Hello and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm very excited because my friend Chloe and I were able to go thrift slash vintage shopping up in Portland. I've only really been able to go shopping in Portland at the major malls, so I was really excited to be able to see a whole different side of the shopping in Portland, and we were really lucky to be able to find some really unique pieces. We ended up going to four different places. A lot of them were recommended by Chloe and her dad, who really loved vintage and thrift shopping already. The first place that we went to is called Buffalo Exchange. It seems like this place would be really great if you're looking for more trendy pieces. I actually had an outfit in mind that I was wanting to find when we were going, and it included these white boots that I've been seeing all over Instagram. They're definitely more of like a statement trendy piece, and I wasn't sure if I'd be able to find anything like that because, you know, going thrifting, you never really know what to expect. But at that store, they had like 10 different white pairs of boots. So really in trend. It seems like they get a lot of things from like Target and Forever 21, that kind of vibe, you know? From there, I got this really cute velvet deep red skirt and the white pair of boots that I was really wanting. Something to note is that they don't offer any shopping bags for you. So you either have to, well, buy your own bag from them or bring your own or carry it out like we did, because we only got a couple of things from there. I would say the prices are pretty fair. For the skirt, I believe I paid around $12, and for the boots, it was around $15. The second place that we went to was called Magpie Vintage. It's a place that really has a vibe of its own. Right when you walk in, they have all of these mannequin heads with different really brightly colored wigs, and as you go throughout the store, they have those continuing along all the walls on shelves, like really high up, down low, so you can try them on. And they have the cutest dog there ever. I feel like it would be worth it to visit just to be able to hang out with that dog. This was the most spendy place that we went to, I'd say, which makes sense because it's a vintage store instead of a thrift store, but the quality seemed to be a lot nicer. From there, I got this really nice blazer style trench coat from Barney's, which was perfect because I really don't have anything in this style. And I felt really lucky because I feel like when it comes to vintage or thrift shopping, even if you find a really amazing piece at a really amazing price, it's not always guaranteed that it's going to fit you. So everything really came together. It felt like fate that I was able to find this really cool jacket. It was the most expensive thing that I got on this trip, at $45. But for the quality of the jacket and how often I feel like I'm going to use it, I feel like it was a very good price. Chloe ended up finding these really cool, unique red cowboy boots that had a bit of a heel on it. It's something that neither of us had really seen before. And because she's going to be moving to New York soon, we both thought that it would be a really cool statement piece to have. The third place that we went to was called The Red Light. I'm not sure if it's really considered a thrift store or not, because they had pieces in more than one size. So maybe they're just a regular clothing store, but the style is definitely not anything that you'd really see going to your average store. They had very quirky, eclectic designs. The style was very bright and sparkly, and I feel like this place would be very good if you're looking for something unique. We didn't end up getting anything here because the things were so unique. We didn't think that we'd wear them very often, and so to us that time it wasn't really worth it to get something that we didn't think we'd really be wearing, but they had really, really cool things, so I think it'd be worth it to check it out. It was really fun to look through the store. The fourth and final place that we went to was Goodwill. We have this here in Salem, but the stores there are definitely much larger. I would say Goodwill is a great place to go to if you're looking for more basic pieces. I was actually wanting to get a black turtleneck, and I was able to find one there that fit me perfectly, and I was so happy about it. If you've never been to Goodwill, something to also keep in mind is every week they have a different color that is 50% off. So on each of the price tags on whatever you're buying, they each have a different circle that's a color. And you can find out on their website, or maybe just even ask anybody who works in the store which color is 50% off that week, and you'll be able to get a lot more for your money that way. Overall, I am really, really happy with everything that we ended up getting. I felt like I've never had a more perfect day of shopping in my life, where we just had things in mind that we were wanting to get and we were able to find all of them at the places that we went to. I would say I definitely want to go thrift / vintage shopping again in Portland really soon. Let me know if any of you have any favorite stores in Portland to check out, or maybe even some places in New York. I don't know if any of you know of any. Since Chloe's going to be moving there soon, maybe I'll come and visit and we can go vintage shopping there. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.